The villagers have been complaining about the quality of the water at the jail. I can't imagine why. They say it tastes rusty. Can't figure it out at all. Alright, welcome back everybody. Here we go again, one more time. So, I think this will probably be the last time I visit the village for a while. Today is going to be a bit of a wander around, and then there's going to be a lot of building involved today. I want to get the slaughterhouse built so that I can have cows and pigs and sheep. Oh no, not sheep, chickens. Anyway, cows and pigs and chickens for the raw meat that the villagers want. I'm going to get a tree farm to convert into charcoal, so I'll have a charcoal factory. And if I have time, there might be a little bit of exploring. I know I got to go and get a few items to get these things, so I'm actually going to start with one thing that I've been kind of putting off, and that is going to the Nether. Now, I wanted to make the Nether a big event and, you know, do a big exploration of it, but I find that in order to do some of the redstone mechanics, I need to make comparators, and of course comparators need the Nether quartz. So I will do a little bit of Nether exploring today, and then maybe in an episode or two we'll actually go and make a big event of the Nether, because the Biomes of Plenty Nether is a lot different than the vanilla Nether. So we will deal with that. I want to do a shout out to James. He gave some great ideas. He's the one who suggested the graveyard, and he's also the one who suggested putting a mausoleum in. So that's what I've done. I went ahead and built up this mausoleum here. I got some vines growing on it, put some iron bars in, but this isn't just an ordinary mausoleum. See, I've got some urns, there's some cremation remains there, but there's something special about this one, and that is, ta-da, we have our sneaky little hidden Nether portal down here. Now, I haven't lit it. I've never been across the other side here, so this will be a big reveal for everybody. Alright, so let us cross the border here. Oh, that actually looks really neat. I was worried about that red and blue. It looked kind of, you know, ridiculous back there, but with the swirly pattern on there, it looks pretty good, actually. I went ahead and made it a 3x3 just to make it symmetrical, because I hate the fact that if I did the normal 2x3, it would be off-center, so luckily Nether portals can be any size you want now. So yeah, I put up a few structures here. I'm probably going to complete the roof. I'll put an arch in here. I just got a little impatient, so I'll do a little bit more decorating, put some other stuff down here, maybe a couple more coffins or tombstones or something down here to make it look like an underground graveyard. But here we go. Let us cross the Nether portal threshold. Oh. Why did I have to spawn in a visceral heap? This biome just creeps me out. It is just gross. This is all living flesh, and it is just, oh, makes my skin crawl thinking about it. But yeah, this is just, ugh. Okay, I'm gonna have to move my portal. I don't wanna have to keep walking in to this visceral heap. Hopefully up there will be something nicer. That looks like ash over there. So yes, this is the visceral heap. It's a Biomes of Plenty, and it is just, it's got pools of blood, and this, just the stuff jumping off the skin there, ugh. And this would be a phantasmagoric inferno. That sounds creepy in of itself. but this ash is really hard to walk through, so let's get off of it. There we go. And soul sand. That's so much easier, isn't it? Jeez. Okay, that is a wasp's nest up there, and those guys are vicious. They can pound you into the ground pretty quick, so we'll want to stay away from that for a while. Oop, nether quartz in the walls there, and of course, some glowstone. So, now that we've seen this, I don't want to spend a lot of time because I don't want to reveal a bunch. I want to save that for another day. So I'm going to go ahead and harvest some of the quartz and the glowstone. And I'm going to try not to die 100 times down here because dying in the nether really sucks. So I will see you back on the surface once I get what I need. Okay, I have to find a way of farming hell rats because they drop redstone and fire. That could get interesting because you can use fire to create all kinds of stuff. Well, you need it to make the essence of fire. I'm not sure what I think these are biomes of plenty from the items that no longer exist, the heaven realm. I'm not sure, but I'm gonna have to look into these. But I can use it to craft the chainmail and essence of fire, which is something from the mole creatures. So, interesting. That's how you get that. Okay, so after my little trip to the nether there, I did some tree farming. I've got some spruces growing there. I was hacking them down. Nether netted me about a stack and a half of quartz. And as you can see, I've got a bunch of spruce already laid out. I did gather up some clay, created some more bricks, because I'm going to go for a wood and brick structure on this slaughterhouse. The cows and pigs have been gathered. I do have some chickens around the corner here. You know, they're starting to lay their eggs already, which is what I need. And pigs I've bred, I've gotten a few started there, and cows. It's going to be a little difficult to get that many cows into a breeding pen, but we'll push them around. So the designs that I found for the pig and chicken, or sorry, the pig and cow slaughter house is a simple 3x6. Basically, you have the cows on one side. The babies breed, they drop down, they come across, and the design that I saw had a lava blade that killed them when they grew up. I'm just going to use a water source to drown them because I don't want the drops to be cooked. I want raw meat. So I'm going to modify it slightly and it's going to be just that easy. Of course, I will have to participate in feeding the cows, waiting for their babies to grow up. So it won't be very fast, but it will be fairly efficient, and same with the pigs. The chickens, however, can be fully automated. You just use a repeating dispenser to spit out the eggs as they're laid, and then the eggs break, the babies come out. When they grow up, they get drowned, and then they drop their feathers and chicken in that way. And that is a 6x5 design that I found. I will have the links to the tutorials I'm going to follow. Today's episode is basically going to be testing how well I can follow instructions, because I'm not the best at creating my own, but I do fairly well when following somebody else's instructions. So instead of spending hours tinkering and trying to find something that works, I'm just going to borrow from those who know better. So I'm going to get started. I'm going to lay down a foundation for the building itself. Then I will designate the cows, the chickens, the pigs, get the rivers running, as you say, you know, as it were, so that the water source, the trails. That's the other thing, water sources. I did figure out why I wasn't getting infinite water, and I did correct that. There is a line in one of the configuration files that makes water finite. I'm not a big fan of that idea, so thanks to a little poking around on the message boards, I did find out why, and I changed that setting. So now I can have infinite water again. It just makes life so much easier when you're used to having infinite water and you don't get it. So I'm going to knock these two trees down, then I'm going to lay down some foundation, and I will be back. Okay, so that goes all the way around. And let's go up a few more. I think we'll put them up maybe 4 or 5 blocks in the air. So then the slaughtering floor will be here, so we'll need... Oh, I didn't bring any chests. Put a couple of chests here for the hoppers to all drop into. And... cows, chickens, that's probably 1 too wide now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yeah, that's 6 wide now. I did screw that up. There. So all of this gets moved over. What a waste of my tools. There. Yeah. There. Oop. I guess I'll do it from down here then. Nope, still not going to be enough. Nope, it's not enough. Alright, I think I've got some more clay. Okay. I think I've got some more clay over here. Or did I already gather these? Haha, success. Last of the bricks. Just looks odd, doesn't it? Oh well. Okay. Take that many for now. Finish what we started. There. And I think this side as well. There. Okay. So, the animals will all be fed. You know what, maybe I should lower... well, no, because I want the chest at level here, so... that's fine. Alright guys, I've gone ahead and made an executive decision on the structure here. I went and did some decorating, of course, with the roof up. But I've also decided to isolate this strictly for the cow breeder. I was experimenting in a test world, in a creative mode, and I cannot get it to work with pigs. Cows, it works just fine. You put the cows in here, and then you feed them wheat, and the babies float down. They go into the little chamber underneath of here, where they spend their little baby cow lives dancing around on top of the hoppers. But when they grow up, it's time to float to the surface, in which they can't reach, so they drowned. It's a humane way to kill them, of course, because you don't have to cook them, you're not slaughtering them, you just let them die, and everything ends up in here. And this way I don't get cooked beef, I need raw beef so that I can trade with the villagers. Pigs, however, when I put the pigs in my test world, the adult pigs would get carried down as well. I can't find a way of getting only the baby pigs to float away. I guess the adult pigs are tall enough, are not tall enough to stay above the water. They get sucked under as well. So I'm still experimenting, trying to find a way of filtering out the pigs so that I can keep the adults separate from the babies. If I can do that, then I'll put a separate chamber here for the adult pigs and have them all carry to the same drowning pit. So for now, this is just going to be for cows. The chicken one, actually, I was experimenting with as well, and it's all enclosed, self-contained unit. So I couldn't find a way of tying it in to this because it has its own drowning chamber that doesn't work with my configuration here. So I think I'm going to build a separate chicken coop, probably on this hill here, just right in this space right in here. Should be plenty of room here. And that will be the chicken, and then the cow slaughter farm, and somewhere probably back in this corner I'll do pigs once I figure it out, unless I can tie it in, like I said. Whoa. What happened there? Alright, I have an Enderman to kill. That was completely unexpected. Okay, you have seriously upset me. Let me just gather up my stuff. And then... Yeah, I didn't mean to hit you. I'm sorry. That first blow was an accident. I wasn't ready. We're just gonna have one of those days, are we? Where are you at? Alright, come on. Yeah, come on. Let me get into an area where I can put a roof over my head. Where are you? Where are you? Yeah. Okay, let me put a roof over my head here. Oops. So you can't get to me. And let's go find you. Where are you? Yeah, let's put my pants back on. Little extra protection. Okay, where is he? Where does the map say he is? Oh, map says he's right over here. Where is he? Oh, yeah, there he is. Get under. Ha ha ha. That's what you get. You dirty. Alright. Now that I was so rudely interrupted. Where was I? Oh yes, pigs. If I can get it to work. Yeah, I don't need this anymore here. Good. I'll tie the pigs in here. And if the pigs need their own separate slaughter farm, then I will put it over there. No big deal. Okay, so that is that. I think I'm going to sleep so that I don't have another interruption. And then we will get the cows floating and leave it at that. Oh, what are you doing here? Jeez. Okay, if skeletons can spawn in here, and creepers, how are you guys getting into my village? I clearly have some dark spots here, because if creepers and skeletons can spawn, then zombies can too. And if zombies can spawn, then my villagers are at risk. And I don't like the idea of my villagers being at risk. Okay, looks like I have some maintenance to do. Something has gone seriously wrong in this village. You'll have to give me a minute. As I was saying, why are you in my village? I have eliminated 8, 7 or lower spots in my village so far. If you look at the brightness level, I've managed to find... Oh, see, I just passed another one. There was another 7 there. Where was it? Okay, there's a torch there. I was wandering through here. Where was it? There's the 8. There's a 7. I had a torch there and a torch there, yet here is a 7. And I can't place one. That's probably why. I got 3 torches. I'm in the middle of 3 torches, but this is a 7. Alright. Oh, there's another one. Did that help? Yeah, that helped. I gotta start using. Yeah, so there's another one. Boy, did I ever fail. Those poor villagers must have been scared out of their minds. Yeah, there's another one. Yeah. There's a torch right there. Alright, I guess I'll put another one there. Yeah, glowstone. Start hiding some stuff. Get rid of these torches. Six. How is there a six? It's a wonder these guys aren't dead already. Alright. Let's see how that does. Alright, let's follow the leader time. Who wants wheat? There we go. Got your attention now. Unless I hit you with it. Jeez, slippery finger with that button right now. Alright, let's see if I can get you two to come. There we go. Come on. Yeah, that's right. Come on. Okay, how about you get out of the way so that he can follow. There we go. Up the stairs. Let me come up here. Come on. Oh, you can't possibly be that dumb. And now you're going to ignore me because I took the weed away. There, got four of them in there. Let's find out how we do. Can I feed them all? Feed one more. There we go. Okay, they're all fed. There goes one baby. There goes two babies. Okay. Now if we come around here... See? They're on the hoppers. They're perfectly safe. Good. They can frolic and dance around on those hoppers all they want. But when they grow up, that's the end of them. I don't know about you, but whenever I picture a slaughterhouse, I think about hanging carcasses. Is that crass? I don't know. Is that too much? So managed to lure a bunch more in, got them trapped in there. I think there's 10 or 12, I kind of lost track. I was bringing them in pairs though, so I know that there's an equal number. We'll never have a lonely cow. So they will continue to bob and float. And I noticed that if I breed them too quickly, sometimes the babies get trapped here and they end up drowning before they grow up. So I'm going to have to be more careful about that, or else I'm going to have to tinker with the design. See, I can still have a few. I've got three... I think I have three in there. And I had at least two die, and they didn't draw up anything, so they didn't grow up. They just died as babies. But I think they got trapped. They weren't able to go under because of the other ones. They got pushed back and held in that little water pocket that gets created when... this water connects to the drowning water here. See, and the two water connect and they create a little pocket there, and I can't seem to solve that either, so... So, for now, I'll just breed them slowly. And then they can grow up and fill the chest slowly. Not a big hurry. I know there are many more efficient designs, but I'm not looking for mass quantities. I'm just looking for something a little bit fun, and you know, just to keep myself busy. I don't want everything to be fully automated. That would be boring. Gotta participate in something. Alright, so on to the chicken coop and then the tree and coal farm, but I think those are gonna have to be hurry up deals because I've been taking way too long with this stupid butcher's shop here. So We'll fast track the chicken coop and the tree and coal farm, and then we'll wrap it up. Alright, so I've got the chicken coop pretty much constructed here. The idea is the adult chickens will sit up here and they'll lay eggs collected by the hopper. They'll spit out by this dispenser, and as they break and produce baby chickens, the babies will settle to the half slab below here. And as soon as they grow up, they get forced into this soul sand water trap, which will be capped off by another glass plate, and then they drowned, and their drops are collected underneath. Now I've elevated it so that I can build the big chicken coop above it, but they get dropped down and put into the chest. So pretty simple redstone wiring. It's just a dispenser repeater, so the typical clock here, you know, you got your comparators, ticks on, fires them out. A little example here. Throw some of these in the hopper. Just like that. Done. Well, it's definitely working. I got two down there now. And once these all grow up, I'll just start feeding them seeds to let them breed, so I get a larger collection up here. The more chickens up here, the faster the eggs lay. The more chickens down there, the faster the drops. So, seeds to feed them, eggs come out here, wheat to feed the cows, babies come there. It all works. There we go, chicken coop complete. And it is also already starting to work. So, the more breeding chickens I get up there, the faster the eggs will drop. Alright, so these two projects took way too long. I'm already running out of time here. So I'm going to bounce back to the cabin in the woods. We're going to cook our supper for the day. And when I come back, I will have the tree farm and coal factory already done. The links to the tutorials I'm following will be in the description, so if you want to see how I built them, they'll be there. I'll give you a quick tour. I'm going to put them, since the animal farms are out this side, on the west of the village, I'm going to take and put the coal factory and tree farm down here to the south. So kind of in that area there. I'm going to clear it all out. Maybe I'll get better at editing my videos and these things can all come together, or maybe I'll just get lazy and not edit anything and we'll just have a whole bunch of different videos. We'll see. Alright, so I've been staring at pigs, chickens, and cows all day, and that means today is a seafood day. I just can't stomach the thought of eating anything else. So we're gonna do the classic fish and chips. So I'm gonna have to make some fish sticks and some french fries. Fish sticks are pretty straightforward. You flour up your fish, throw them in a bakeware, and oops, the french fries, you bake up some potatoes and salt. So the only thing we're gonna need to use today is the bakeware, which is actually really convenient. So let's grab the bakeware, and up here we can grab some salt. Let's make two orders just in case, because I am getting hungry. And where's my potatoes? Two potatoes. One potato, two potato. And some fish. One, two. And do I have any flour made, or am I going to have to grind up? I don't see. And nope, looks like I am going to have to pull some flour. So I will need the mortar and pestle, which is this guy here. And can I make rice flour? I can't remember. Nope, you can make rice cakes, though. I don't remember seeing that before. Or can I make flour? Oh, it does make flour. Okay. And I believe oats makes flour as well, doesn't it? Yes. Okay, so let's grab a couple of oats. I don't want to waste the rice because I'm really waiting to get some seaweed because sushi is on my list, and I will be making sushi as soon as I get some seaweed. So the bakeware can stay in there, and we're going to flour our fish, get our fish and chips by doing this, salt and potatoes. And then you just combine the two. Pretty straightforward. Okay, actually, you know what? Let's experiment. Let's see if eating them separately is different than eating them apart. So I've got, what is that, 2.5 hunger. Step out here. So we have 2.5 hunger. So French fries gives me 2, and fish sticks gives me 2.5. Okay, now I'm gonna go, so that's a combined 4.5. Let's see what the fish and chips gives us. I'm gonna go get some exercise, wear down my hunger, and we will see what the fish and chips gives us, see if it's better than 4.5. All right, so I brought myself down to 2 hunger. Now let's see, we gotta beat 4.5, right? So let me give him fish and chips. Let's gotta beat 4.5. Gave me 1, 2, 3, 4.5. So combined, they give me the same as separate. Well, I guess you can't really ask for more than that. At least it's one item you eat rather than two. It would have been nice if you got a little bonus. Oh, hey, skeleton horse. Yeah, if they'd added a little bit of a bonus. Oh, and then he's got a zombie riding him. Isn't that cute? So. Yeah, so if the fish and chips had given me like 5 instead of 4.5, that would have been nice. But I can settle for 4.5. It's just one item rather than 2. And kill the horse. And the zombie floats. And he burns. It burns. All right. There we go. Sorry about the confusion over this episode. I thought I'd get more done, but, you know, be that as it may, we will return in the next time and move on. All right. Take it easy.